is what we've all been waiting for.
In just a few moments, the individuals who drew number one and number two will be Royal Rumble.
Oh, my God.
And every 2 minutes thereafter, another individual will enter the ring according to the number he pulled. Remember, in the Royal Rumble, it is and elimination occurs when a wrestler is thrown out over the top and onto the floor. Now, the man who will win the Royal Rumble and the one man remaining after all 30 participants have entered will be crowned the undisputed World Wrestling Federation Champion.
Very simple, it's over the top and down to the concrete
to make a brief statement prior to the Rumble's beginning. It gives me a great deal of pleasure to introduce to you the esteemed president of the World Wrestling Federation, Mr. Jack Tunney.
President Jack Tunney,
Thank you very much, Howard. I would like to take this opportunity to officially welcome everyone who is watching this spectacular event with us. The winner of this event will not only have the prestige of beating 29 other men, but will also be declared the undisputed World Wrestling Federation Champion.
Come on, let's go.
I would like to say in closing, may the best man win.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
He's been the best president since Noriega.
Will you be serious?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let us all find out
who drew
number one for the Royal Rumble.
President Jack Tunney is certainly. It's Davey Boy. The British Bulldog. The winner of the coveted Samovar Trophy at the Royal Albert Hall.
We were there.
We certainly were. Of course, there was only 19 men involved in that one. This one here is 29 guys, Brandon. He's going to have to go through.
Shut up. Who's number
two? And now, here is the individual who drew number two.
Should be on the cover of GQ.
The Royal Rumble is underway. Every 2 minutes, the next participant will appear. DiBiase has done very well in the Royal Rumbles of late.
See, my strategy would be right now. You can't get counted out. Go between the ropes. Take a walk. Kill some time. I mean, you're the first and second out here. You could be in there for a long time.
Well, I believe it was last year, Brain, last year's Royal Rumble, where Million Dollar Man was in there for in excess of 30 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Well, let's set the record straight. It is the model, Rick Martel, who has the record, 53 minutes and I believe 14 seconds. Of course, that was for the one who was in there the longest. The one who was in there the shortest, a very dubious honor, goes to Bushwhacker Luke. I believe it was 4.8 seconds. He whacked his way in and immediately got whacked out.
He was in there totally too long.
DiBiase's out of there!
Okay, who's number three? Who's number three now?
Just like that!
How much more time do we have?
Davey Boy! Look at, he's upset. An opportunity wasted down
Nine
the drain
seconds,
here.
8 seconds, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Listen to this tremendous crowd counting down here. There goes the buzzer.
No!
Oh, yes!
Damn it!
It's Ric Flair! Who has drawn numbers 1 through 5, been there at the end.
Watch your language. Sit down before you have a heart attack.
That's okay. I know Perfect's got him ready. He's confident.
Did you hear what I just said?
What? You talking to me?
Yes.
What'd you say?
No one ever in the history of the Royal Rumble has drawn numbers 1 through 5 and been there at the end.
Oh, shut up!
Take your time, champ. Pace yourself. I'm gonna have to apologize to the people. I don't think I can really be objective. I'm gonna have to make...
When have you ever been objective?
Oh, no.
Oh, look at this power press slam!
Oh.
Take a walk, take a walk. Go under the rope.
Flair looks to be in tremendous condition. He'll have to be. He wants to get very far in this one.
Take it easy, Rick. Take a walk. See, he's too much of a competitor to do that. He's gonna fight you right up until the end.
How
Which I hope is after 29 other men have been eliminated.
How unfortunate. For the executive consultant and the financial advisor,
shut up,
to lose their jobs because this guy, with the luck of the draw, went with number 3.
Who's coming out now?
And you can hear him counting down. The next competitor is on his way.
The Sags of the Nasty Boys. A 300-pound guy.
One half of the Nasty Boys. Sags making his way down.
What tremendous camera work. I've got to get my mind off this. I got to talk about something else.
Yeah, your career is in jeopardy, Brain. Well, this should buy a little time for Ric Flair here. As now it's a double team on Davey Boy.
Flair. Let Sags do all the work. Over in the corner and rest. You got over 2 minutes.
Now listen, you're supposed to be a broadcast journalist. Be objective here.
I told you to shut up. Leave me alone. I stand a chance of making a fortune here.
Or losing one.
I can't look at it that way. I'm going to be on easy street.
One man has been eliminated already, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, much to his chagrin. Oh, nice counter move by Davey Boy. Incidentally, President Jack Tunney certainly was
No,
going all over the world. Drop kick, and he's out.
No. It's back to Bulldog and Flair.
And Davey said, it's you and me, Flair.
This isn't fair to Flair. This is not fair to Flair.
It certainly is. All's fair in the Royal Rumble.
Whoa. Sound like a 357 Magnum.
Well, the countdown is there. We're down to 7
Six.
Now. Let's see who's going to be coming out. As Flair's in trouble.
Who's coming out now?
Haku.
It's Haku.
But, you know, you can't really depend on anybody to help you because it's every man for themselves.
Absolutely.
Everyone wants the gold.
Haku immediately attacking Davey Boy. A nice opportunity for Flair to catch a breather here. He certainly needs it. But now he's attacking.
Back off, Rick. Let Haku do the kicking. Oh, safe!
Oh, there it is!
heck are you going, Haku? Have you gone nuts?
Just to show you, it's every man for himself. Every guy that comes out here.
This isn't fair to Flair. I'm telling you. There are no friends, Monsoon. Only enemies. 30 enemies.
Flair's got to get back in there.
You know what it's
what
called?
The referees are there for.
You know what it's all about? The World Wrestling Federation title.
Oh, look at this. Pile driver by Haku. And now Flair taking advantage of the situation. Goes to work on Haku. What a competitor. I'll give you that.
Take it easy, Rick. You're not going to hurt him doing that to his head. Take a breather. Where's Perfect?
They're not allowed at ringside, Brain. You know that.
He's not a manager. He's an executive consultant.
Same thing. A pest. Oh, nice reverse knife edge and a headbutt by Haku.
Come on, Davey boy. Get Haku.
On earth would you want to raise the ire of this big guy?
Stay down, Rick. Stay down. Take it, count it up.
Clock is down to 8 seconds. We're going to have another competitor out here in just a moment.
It's back to Bulldog and Flair. This isn't fair to Flair, I keep telling you.
Who is it? Oh. Shawn Michaels.
It doesn't matter who comes out, really. It's every man for themselves.
It does matter. Some guys hate Flair more than others.
You're jealous is what it is.
This.
There's no way you could hate that man.
Shawn Michaels going to work on Ric Flair. Big back drop. Oh.
No.
Press and kick. Look at Michaels. He's going after everybody. Oh, power slam again. Davey boy.
That's right, Rick. Stay down. Take it easy. Let them fight it out.
Oh, 360.
No, he's not out.
He didn't go to the floor.
Not out.
He went to the apron.
Back off, Rick. Back off. The roof's starting to spin. I'm getting dizzy.
Look at this.
Somebody get me something to drink.
Trying to get Michaels out of there. Oh. Finger right in the eye.
Give me some water. Give me something to drink.
Davey boy taking a whole lot of punishment so far.
Give me something with a kick.
Don't forget he was the first one out there.
By my watch.
A negative attitude.
By my watch, Flair's been in over 10 minutes already. So is Davey boy. Bring it over 12, probably. Who could it be?
Another entry about to emerge through the curtains here.
He's not out.
It's Alberto Tito Santana. Well, this won't buy any time for Flair.
Former Intercontinental Champion, former Tag Team Champion. He'd love to be World Wrestling Federation Champion. And he's got as good a chance as anybody.
Immediately goes to work on Ric Flair, trying to dump him out.
No, no,
upside down.
No,
in the corner.
Perfect. Get out here.
Kiss your meal ticket goodbye.
Ric, go down. Stay down.
Just hanging in there. It's a tag team effort here, even though it's every man for himself, as Davey Boy and Tito were in. Oh,
what a
suplex
Flair
by Flair.
Flair could lay back.
Excuse
me. He could take it easy, but he's a competitor.
Just about out of there. Nope. Only to the apron. Did you see that? Talk about desperation.
You know what's at stake? A man will do anything.
Holding out all the stops. Ric Flair doing whatever necessary to hang in there.
I'd do that to my grandmother if I had to.
I'm sure you would. Davey Boy over that top rope, but not out of there yet. Down on the apron, scoots back in underneath. Santana, look out. Forearm found the mark. Look at Flair.
All over the place.
Look at Flair. As another entry about to emerge.
Who is it? Who is it?
It's the Barbarian.
Oh, they don't get any smaller. They just get bigger. They just get tougher.
Barbarian doesn't like Flair.
Barbarian doesn't like anybody. When I managed him, he barely liked me. Why do you think they call him the Barbarian? He's not a hairdresser on his day off, you know. This is one tough guy.
Tito Santana wide open for that shot by Flair. And look at Barbarian. Got Davey Boy up there, but he's holding. What tremendous conditioning shown here by Davey Boy Smith, and of course,
he's got a death grip on that top rope.
Sooner or later, Brain, you reached a point where the tank is empty. And then, I don't care how good an athlete you are, it's you're over. Right for the pickings.
And you know, it's not like a regular tag match. It's not like a single match. He could be in there with 12 guys, 15 guys, 20 guys. I mean, and you know what's at stake? You have a chance to become a millionaire in one afternoon.
Tito Santana holding his own. He can with the best. Got some very impressive credentials. Look out. Shawn Michaels perched there on that second turnbuckle on the inside, just waiting for the opportune moment.
Flair's doing the smart thing, though.
Yeah, he's running
back.
Taking a breather. I don't blame him.
It's the mark of a champion.
Oh, look at this.
Michaels has been out about three or four times and back in. So is the Bulldog.
But they can't get him down to the
floor. Now he's on his way out.
We're going to have another entry here in just a moment. And here he comes. There goes the horn. Oh, it's a Texas Tornado.
They just keep getting bigger.
Another former Intercontinental Champion.
He'd love to have that gold. No silver, no bronze today. It's just all gold, Monsoon.
Ric Flair. What a man he is.
I don't feel
immediately
good.
Immediately challenging the Texas Tornado.
Man.
Where a lot of other guys would have laid low.
Whoa. Oh, come on, Rick.
It's amazing when you come through that curtain and hit that squared circle. You've got everything going for you, and some of these other guys are in bad shape. Makes for easy pickings.
There are no friends. Every man for himself.
Look at this slingshot. Davey Boy was number one. He's still there.
Hey, the best way to win this, you come to the ring and you carry a wrench. A big crescent wrench.
It has been 16 minutes since Davey Boy entered the ring. And he has been just beaten from pillar to post here.
He's been over, he's been out, he's been back and forth, but his feet have not touched the ground. Remember, your feet have to touch the ground after being thrown over the top rope.
I know the rules.
Well, I'll make sure you know. Just you just call the action, stay off my case.
Flair down on the canvas once again. Not the place to be in the Royal Rumble with that many arms and legs running around out there. This is where you could sustain a very serious injury. As the clock boils down once again, who's it gonna be?
You got me.
Oh, it's the Repo Man. Look it, he don't even know which direction the ring is.
He's taking his time. He's got a plan. He knows what to do.
He's wasting valuable time.
Oh, he's not. He knows what he's doing.
Yeah.
Take your time. Smart guy.
Once again, Flair trying to get rid of Davey Boy. Unsuccessfully.
Look at the grip Davey Boy has on that second rope.
Tito Santana ducks the clothesline. What a high cross body, but pinfalls do not count.
Submissions do not count. You gotta go 15 feet over to that floor.
The dangerous aspect of this Royal Rumble, it boils down to come into focus because the number of men inside the ring is increasing.
It boils down to how bad you want it.
Haven't had anyone eliminated in the last 5 or 6 minutes.
Who's out so far? DiBiase and Sags, right? So that means there is a chance there could be 28 men filling this ring up. Let's see, 22 for 20.
13.
Yeah, 28.
How about Haku?
27.
Whoa! Reverse knife edge by Flair, finding the mark. What devastating shots those were. 16 minutes now for Flair.
I know, I'm keeping time on it.
So that means coming close to 20 minutes for Davey Boy. Oh no, it's gotta be over the top.
We had it budgeted for 30. We didn't want him to go any more than 30.
We're gonna have another participant coming through right now, and it is the Hammer Valentine.
How long was he in last year, Monty?
Last year in the Royal Rumble, the Hammer was in there for 44 minutes and 20 seconds exactly.
Now here's a former Intercontinental Champion, former WWF Tag Champion, and he wants the big one.
You know, it takes him that long to get warmed up.
And don't forget, still to come, Randy Macho Man Savage, Sergeant Slaughter, The Undertaker, Hulk Hogan, all former WWF champions.
How about the reigning Intercontinental Champion?
I was just going to say that. I don't feel it.
Look at the Hammer go to work on Flair.
Now that's not fair.
Look at Davey Boy. We can see the fatigue setting in on this youngster.
We didn't want Flair. Pepper told me he didn't want Flair to go any more than 30. We figured he'd get number maybe 18 or 20. That'd be all right. We never expected he'd be jobbed like this and be given number 3.
Brain, why don't you just forget about it, Brain? I told you, no one ever has drawn at numbers 1 through 5 and been there at the end.
Up. Shut up!
If the Hammer should repeat his performance of last year and be able to hang in there for 40 minutes or so now with the number he was selected, then he would be the winner, wouldn't he?
That's right.
And I'm Flair would sit be here the loser, wouldn't he?
Flair would, no, look.
And what so is, would a lot
Michaels
of other
almost gone. Michaels is almost gone.
That's why this Royal Rumble is so important and so difficult, because anybody, even an underdog, even a long shot, a dark horse, could become the next champion. Here we go. It's Nikolai Volkov,
320-pound Lithuanian.
Well, things are pretty rough right now over there for those Russians.
Too bad.
What a feather in the cap it would be for Nikolai.
Yeah, he can
pick up the goal
belt
here. Davey Boy now in there in excess of 20 minutes.
That's about what for Flair? 17, 18?
That's 16 plus for Flair. What a testament to the conditioning of these athletes.
Shawn Michaels has been out there a while too. Look at, listen to the Hammer just pounding away Flair. Oh, listen to that.
Shawn Michaels face down in the center of the ring. Not the place to be.
Davey Boy back on Flair again. This isn't right.
I think it's fair.
Not the Flair.
Repo Man going to work.
Valentine, no! No!
Waiting for a red block being slapped on.
No!
On Ric Flair.
I'll tell you, that's a brilliant move. I never thought of it. You take a
there goes Nikolai.
You take a man's legs out from under him, that saps all your strength.
Volkoff is out of there. That didn't take long, did it? You know, just when you're least expected, when you think you're doing so great, when you think you've got everything under control from the blind side, here comes somebody, and you're out of there.
You never know what's going to happen. Any schlemiel can win this.
As we hear this capacity crowd counting it down here, another contestant about to enter. Oh, it's a big boss man.
Oh, no. Has he got his nightstick? Has he got his handcuffs?
No, he does not.
What a travesty if this big country bunker would walk away the winner.
Look at the boss man unload on everybody.
And don't forget, every 2 minutes, a man comes out and they're fresh. Fresh. That means they're going to be fighting a man who's been in there over
10 years. Oh, the hammer won't make it this year. He's out of there.
The Bulldog's still in. Flair's still in.
Look at the difference in the speed of the guys that have just come in and the guys that have been in there for a while. That's what makes this event so fantastic.
It makes it so dangerous.
Where's Flair?
Flair's over there in the corner with Santana.
Whoa!
Repo's gone. Repo's gone. See, the more people that get thrown out, that means the more people, the more attention drawn to Flair.
Uh-oh, Flair now trapped in the corner there between Davey Boy and Tino Santana.
I'm a nervous wreck.
He's getting hammered. He's getting hammered.
Get out of that corner. I gotta go to ringside, Monster.
Oh, you're not going anywhere. You stay right here. Do your job. 22 minutes for Flair and counting. That means 26 to up.
Davey Boy.
No. Davey Boy's out of there. And a shoulder lift. What a lift. What a showing by. And there goes the tornado.
Rick, get out of the way of that big country hit. Get away from Boss Man. He outweighs you by 50 pounds. 60 pounds, maybe.
And we're down under that 10-second mark once again before we get another fresh contender.
Manador and Sean are both out.
They certainly are. Look out.
Now the power of Hercules.
Hercules.
That means right now, Flair has been in there longer than anyone so far this year.
That's correct.
Hercules goes right after Flair. What's wrong with you, Hercules?
Maybe he remembers how you treated him.
Every man for himself.
Well, a high five there. With Flair about ready.
No.
And sucker.
Don't turn on him, Rick. Don't turn on him, hit. Rick, don't. No.
Flair trying to use a little reverse psychology. Could backfire here. This power! Whoa! You
Rick,
can't
please.
Take too many of those.
Get out, get out. Crawl under. What happens if he crawls out to the floor? That's okay, right?
As long as he doesn't go over the top.
Take a hike, take a hike.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, my God.
Oh, so long, Flair.
Oh, my God, no.
Oh, look at that. Hercules dumping Barbarian and now. Flair.
Bossman
came on the apron.
Oh, no.
Now he's saying, it's you and me, Flair.
I need oxygen.
I think it's Flair who's going to need the oxygen. Oh, clothesline by the boss man.
Hold on, Flair, been in now.
Flair in excess of 20-something minutes now. Coming up on 30 minutes, I do believe.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, no.
Oh, nice move. Boss Man, with his feet hit the ground.
Flair wins it. Flair's the champion of the world. Flair wins it.
What? Are you kidding? There's a lot more guys. A lot more still to come.
Take a breather.
That's his chance.
Listen to me.
Get a little break here.
Take your time. You got 7 seconds.
Boy, is he hurting. Sucking, trying to get that oxygen in that body. And here comes... Roddy!
Oh, no. Of all the people, anyone but Piper.
It's Piper.
Piper could be done. Oh, Jesse, this isn't fair to Flair. Of all the things
it's
I said
before, it's the Intercontinental Champion.
Definitely
going bananas. Unloading with a backdrop.
Flair must have taken 25 backdrops today.
And Flair scoots out underneath.
Great, what a move. He's after you.
He Roddy's going out there to get him. He knows he's going to have him inside the ring.
They're going to go there. You got a hatred here. You know how Piper feels about that, man. I doubt if he even cares about winning that title. He's got one, but he'd rather keep Flair from winning. He'll do anything he can.
Don't kid yourself for a moment, Brain. Hot Rod's thinking about that title just like everybody else is.
Stop him, stop him. I've never seen Ric Flair in all the years I've known him.
Oh, look at that.
A beating like that.
What a move by Flair, but Piper, just too much for that kind of move.
Oh, come on.
27 minutes for Flair and counting.
Oh,
look
no.
at this. Fireman's carry into an airplane spin.
Oh, no, come on.
So long, Flair.
No, you don't know where he's at.
And a sleeper.
That's what he won the Intercontinental with. If he even gets him half groggy, half puts him out, he can dump him. I know he can dump him if that happens.
Hot Rod could have taken him right out of there with a shoulder block or a drop kick as Flair just baby.
He's choking the life out of him.
And another contestant about to emerge. 5 seconds and counting.
He's got to get him up on his feet to throw him out, though.
Who's it going to be? Jake the Snake Roberts.
Trust me, maybe one of the most dangerous men walking the face of this earth. He knows what he's doing. You don't want to get involved. He's too smart for that.
He's inviting Piper over.
Piper could be doing permanent damage.
Piper's got the
Jake,
right idea.
Go get
he's
him.
Holding on to Flair.
Thank you, Jake. Thank you.
Jake broke that up in a hurry. Look at Flair. He is spent. He's out of it.
Can't trust Jake either.
We all know can't that. Trust anyone in the Royal Rumble.
But especially this man. Flair's starting to move.
Listen to the chant from this capacity crowd.
It's Roddy. People.
Look at
glassy-eyed. He's glassy-eyed.
Oh, look at this. Short clothesline.
You no good.
You just said thanks, Jake.
You can't trust the Snake. I've always said that. It's definitely not fair to Flair.
What a tremendous Royal Rumble.
How long's he been in now?
30 minutes and counting.
No, no.
Almost a DDT.
I never thought I'd say this, but thank you, Roddy. It's a kilt. It's not a skirt. It's a kilt.
Oh, it's a figure four by Ric Flair on Jake the Snake. And look at Roddy, he's giving it to both of them.
Well, you no good creep, you skirt-wearing freak. It's not a kill, it's a skirt.
I can't believe Flair's still on his feet.
I'm soaking wet. My shirt, I'm soaking wet.
Look at Flair pulling out all the stops here.
I'll tell you, I bet you Flair's lost 6 or 7 pounds already.
Almost over the top, Roddy was. And there's another man on his way. Have to leave that outside the ring. But he's fresh and he's ready to go. And going right after Flair. Hard into the turnbuckle. I gotta
listen to my voice.
I gotta say this, Brain. Ric Flair has really shown me something. Even if he doesn't win this, which is highly unlikely that he would, he has shown me some intestinal fortitude, some tremendous conditioning. This guy is a great athlete.
I mean, he's taken a beating. He has taken a beating.
Just too bad he got number three.
We were jobbed, Monsoon. We were jobbed. It's a conspiracy. Hulk Hogan has something to do with this.
And look at this. Flair had an opportunity there to step aside as the other guys were mixing it up, but no, walked right in there, continued the battle.
He's a real world champion, as far as I'm concerned. No matter what happens here, you gotta admit that. Look at him, he's still on his feet, he's still going. He's been slammed, he's been press slammed, he's been back dropped, he's been put to sleep, and he's still fighting. Why? Because he wants it. He's a champion. He's what a champion is made of. There he is, man, a champion to the end.
Reverse side bench by Roddy Piper, and now they're just duking it out, Piper and Flair.
Oh, this isn't fair. This isn't fair to Flair.
Well, we're underneath that 10-second mark once again, which means another entry will be coming into the arena in just a moment. And here he comes. There's the Bulletin buzzer.
IRS.
It is early.
IRS.
Scheister, and in no great hurry to get there.
He's got a plan. He's a smart man. The dumb ones are the ones that run to the ring. They waste energy. Look at Piper. He's down. Look at Flair. Keeps coming. He keeps coming. I know, IRS. I know what he's doing. He's calculating exactly how many deductions he's going to have to make. Who's going to be audited? Who's going to have to pay?
Everybody has to pay sooner or later.
And he's right now,
it's IRS who's pointing. Finally, somebody reached out and grabbed that tie and made him pay the price for wearing it.
Look at Flair. He's still fighting.
Flair just teetering along with Hot Rod on that top rope. Look at this double noggin knocker by Hacksaw. He broke that up in a hurry. You notice that every time that buzzer goes off, Jake the Snake turns around, gets more paranoid.
I know why.
He doesn't know when the Macho Man is coming.
And he's worried. That's in the back of his mind. As much as he wants that WWF gold, he doesn't want any part of Macho Man Savage. And he knows how Savage feels. How long's Flair been in
there? 36 minutes and nine for Ric Flair.
And he's still fighting. He's still fighting.
Oh, Roddy almost had him going there, but Flair put the brakes on. Now we're under 10 seconds.
No.
Once again, as we will get a fresh entry, let's take a pigski and see who it is. There goes the buzzer. Superfly Albino, Jimmy Snuka.
Jimmy Snuka, I mean. See? He's jogging. He's wasting time. He's wasting energy. He's not conserving his strength or his time.
He's not wasting time.
I don't know what I'm saying anymore.
I know you don't. Uh-oh, look at this. Flair perched up there. Hacksaw almost had it. Oh, headbutt. And a beauty.
I don't know how Flair can take much more, Matsu. I really don't.
I know you can't take much more.
I'm not sure if that WWF title's worth it. This could be career ending, you know that.
What a job Flair is doing in this one. And still, some of the heavy hitters yet to come.
Undertaker.
We haven't seen Undertaker,
Hogan,
Sid Justice, the Hulkster, who's won it for the past 2 years in a row. Sergeant Slaughter. And the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Well, we reached that point where the Hulkster, along with the Undertaker, were given that preferential treatment. Their numbers could be coming up at any time, Ray. Big trouble for you.
What a beating Flair has taken. He's got him by the beak.
Oh, look at the eyes of Ric Flair.
No.
Almost out of there. Almost out of there.
Take a beating like this. Look at the welts on his back, from the back drop, from the body slam, from the pounding. Like I said, I don't know if it's worth it.
Uh-oh, we're down under that 10-second mark once again. And this tremendous crowd is counting it down.
This is the greatest.
Take a look. Who is it?
Royal Rumble.
say he's had a bad break, Frank. I thought he'd be farther down the line than this.
Who knows? It's the luck of the draw. Bugsy doesn't make it matter to him if he's number one or number 30. He's ice cold.
He's just gonna go in there and annihilate people.
He's a monster. Look at him. Look at him. Believe me, here's a man who has no power.
Here's a man shot. And Super flies out of there.
And Flair goes right after him. What is wrong with you, Rex? What is wrong with you? He's got a death grip around his neck.
Right around the throat of Ric Flair.
It's over. It's over. Everything down the toilet.
Why don't you show some mercy? Go down there and throw the towel in.
Down the pipe. Everything. Thank you, Duggan. Get him off him. Whoa! 2 points.
Whoa. Amazing what you can do when you're fresh and you come in there. And some of these guys already have spent, in the case of Flair, more, I would say 3/4 spent.
How long's he been in now?
Flair's been in there over 32 minutes now.
Oh, God.
And still on his feet. Can you believe it? Finally got The Undertaker's attention, if that's what he wanted.
Don't wake him up.
Oh! Here comes our next entry. Oh, it's the Macho Man! Look out, Jake the Snake!
Look out, Jake! He's looking for Jake.
He's got him! Can he find him? No.
He got blindsided by The Undertaker. He didn't even know who hit him or what hit him.
Look at Jake, boy, he ran out of there like a snake. But now he sees Savage in trouble. He wants back in there.
Look at Flair, he's still fighting. Back off, will you, Rick?
Fighting.
Take a breather.
I can't believe he's still standing.
Over 40 minutes.
Short clothesline misses. Look out. Macho Man going bananas on Jake the Snake.
Macho Man's gonna tear him apart.
What a Royal Rumble. Double axe handle. Savage with a high knee and Jake is out of there.
Savage is out too. Savage is out, he went over the top to get him. He made a mistake of a lifetime.
Undertaker went underneath that bottom rope, but I think the Macho Man has eliminated himself. What a mistake.
I think he did.
That's what happens when your heart takes over your mind.
You can't let your loved ones control your pocketbook.
Well, Undertaker threw him back in, but I don't think that's going to help him.
Oh, I know what it is, Monsoon. Savage wasn't thrown over the top rope, so that means he can go back in. No one threw him over the rope. I believe that's one of the rules of the Royal Rumble.
I'll have to check that out, right? I'll take your word for it right now.
Well, see, the referee's letting him go back in.
He certainly is.
Somebody has to throw
him. You have to be propelled by someone else.
Oh, my goodness. And Flair is still in there fighting. Take it easy, will you?
Hot Rod just inching him up higher and higher on that top turnbuckle.
For The Undertaker, just the whites of his eyes.
Not the place to be down on the canvas in a Royal Rumble. You gotta try to stay on your feet whenever possible.
Look at Flair. Flair's still moving. He still wants to fight. Is that a champion, Monsoon?
It certainly is. No question about it.
Hey, I gotta give him credit too. Piper just won the Intercontinental title, and he's in there. He's still in there fighting.
Hot Rod giving it his all. He could make history. Right here in the Knickerbocker Arena.
He has such an ego problem. I think he'd love to just make history by being two titles.
Can you believe this? Flair is dishing out offensive maneuvers.
Uh-oh, he just tried to lift The Undertaker.
He did not.
One way or the other.
Deliberate low blow. We've got another one coming out. Let's take a look here. Who is it?
And what's his specialty?
The Berserk.
What's his specialty?
Pick him up and throw him over the top rope and out.
To the floor.
What a tremendous number to come up with, 22.
And he is as fresh as a daisy, all 310 pounds of him.
Goes to work immediately on The Undertaker, and now he wants a shot at everybody.
Where's Rick? Where's Flair?
I don't see him. Where is he?
Oh, no.
Oh, there he is.
Still in there. He's still
working
on
the outside of Randy Savage.
Have you lost your mind? Are you nuts? Take it easy. Go underneath the bottom rope, go under the ring, and right alone.
Rapidly approaching 45 minutes.
Weasel your way out. I never thought I'd say that, but weasel your way out if you have to.
Weasel your way out.
Do anything. This is the final hour, Monsoon. Look at his eyes, look at his eyes. Flair, Flair, Flair on the apron.
He's on the apron.
Oh, are you nuts?
He's trying to suplex Savage out over that top, but the Macho Man has hooked that bottom rope. He's going to turn this around with a suplex of his own, it looks like.
Here comes The Undertaker.
Yes. He got him. How many of those can Flair take?
I'm surprised he's still standing. He still can move. Flair been in now.
Well, Flair's been in there over 45 minutes. He has surpassed Rick Martel's numbers. He is...
No, not Martel.
He just passed Valentine.
Yeah,
he's Martel. Approaching Rick Martel's record as we're going to get another entry here. Let's take a look. Oh, it's Virgil. Fresh and hungry.
Boy, is he ever. He went right after IRS. Don't forget, at one time he had that million-dollar championship belt.
Certainly did.
Of course, he stole it, but he still had it.
He did not. And look at this. Flair trying to get rid of Hacksaw.
Just think, Virgil's, he just came out, right?
Yes.
Number 23, right? Who knows how many bags he's gone through in the back.
Will you stop?
Looks like Hogan lucked out so far, Monsoon.
Well, the title, what it's all about here. Undisputed WWF champion will be crowned here. Which one of these guys is going to get it? How about the guys that
look at this?
The
look at
the
this.
Brain?
Look at this. He's choking the life right out of Flair. Don't get up, Rick. Stay down. Oh, no.
I believe this is the beginning of the end here for Ric Flair.
Look at the grip, look at Flair.
Got nothing to be ashamed of.
You're gonna have to kill him to get him out of this ring. How long's he been in now?
47 minutes for Ric Flair.
And he hasn't taken one back step.
Wayne, he's only 5 minutes away from setting the record. Virgil and Piper duking it out. No friends here. And that's a rumble.
Rowdy Piper's the one that had Virgil see the light. Now they turn on each other.
Here's the countdown. We've got another one just about to emerge. Oh, it is. Oh, this guy's dangerous. Mustafa. And now leading the way down.
He's very dangerous.
By the time they get there, another guy will be on his way in.
What a great battle plan.
Oh, look at this. IRS really hung up there. What a dangerous position he was in. And the Berserker just hammering away at Virgil. What a shot by Savage.
To The Undertaker. Doesn't faze him. Savage has a lot of guts. He'll go right after you. No. Former Intercontinental Champion, former World Wrestling Federation Champion.
The fatigue factor has got to be entering in here.
One person at the concession stands, pal. They're all.
Worldwide audience, this is going all over the world. A special hello to all our friends at Sky TV over there in England. You know they're watching.
Come on, Rick. Yes.
Where is he?
He's in the corner there with Savage.
There he is, still on his feet. Can you believe this? I can't.
His chest is beat red. He's got a welt right in the middle of his forehead.
Oh. This capacity crowd is telling us that the next one is about to come on. And there he is, the current record holder, Rick Martel. What a number he got in the draw. Holy mackerel.
How long did he go last year?
He holds the record at 52 minutes and 34 seconds. He won't have to go half of that to win this.
No. Boy, did Hogan luck out. And Sid Justice. And Sergeant Slaughter.
Well, he had the record for the longest. And of course, we told you earlier on that Bushwhacker Luke had the record for the shortest.
Who cares about
his way down
Bushwhacker
there.
Luke.
4.8 seconds later, he was whacked out.
How long's Flair been in now, Monsoon?
50 minutes.
50 minutes. Almost approaching 1 hour.
2.5 minutes away from the record. He might not make it.
I'll tell you, I got all the confidence in the world.
Mustafa, he's out of there. It is mayhem.
I got all the confidence in the world.
Oh, there he goes.
There. But it don't look good. It just doesn't look good.
Rick Martel, fresh, going to work. Eric Flair, who has to be completely spent at this point in time.
Don't forget, Piper's already wrestled a match, won the Intercontinental Championship, and he's close to the 30-minute mark himself.
Piper almost out there, 25 minutes plus. What a shot he's got at making history here by winning both titles.
How about Hogan? He still has a chance of being 5-time World Wrestling Federation champion.
We're gonna get another entry as the curtains part. We hear the buzzer. It's the
everyone standing. Look at that, the immortal Hulk Hogan, 4-time World Wrestling Federation champion. And he's never a 5th time.
And he goes right after Flair.
Right for Flair.
Well, luckily the Undertaker stepped in there.
It don't look good, Monsoon.
Or it would have been all over.
Please let him win it, please. I'm sorry for everything I've done, everything I've said. Please let him win it.
Will you stop begging?
I'll never say anything bad again about anybody.
Still looking to dish out some kind of punishment. As they've got the Hulkster trapped in the corner.
Just let Flair win it. I'll be a different person, I promise you.
Whoa. Boy, have I heard that before. Hulk off the ropes, yes, clothesline. And Undertaker's gone. Undertaker's out of there. Berserker!
Imagine putting up the Undertaker and the Berserker within 10 seconds.
Ah, oh, there goes Virgil. Virgil and Hacksaw are history. All you gotta know, Brain, is that Flair is still there.
Flair's still in. Piper's still in. Hogan, look
and
at it.
And we're about to get another one. It's Skinner.
fit right in your mouth. That would take it out of you.
Look at Hot Rod.
Look at this. Look at this.
Oh,
no.
Goodbye, Rick. He's over that top rope.
No. I'll behave. I'll never do anything wrong again. Just let him stay.
What a clever maneuver. Flair was over that top rope, grabbed on a Hulk Hogan's leg.
I'm soaking wet. I need something to drink. Hey, you stupid. Give me something to drink. But what a kick.
Getting down to the nitty-gritty here in the Royal Rumble. Should Flair hang on for 60 seconds more, he will be the all-time record holder in the Royal Rumble.
He has taken it to the greatest of the World Wrestling Federation, and he's still there fighting.
Well, I said earlier on, Brain, nobody picks numbers 1 through 5, and he's still there at the end. But we're rapidly approaching the end, and Flair is still there.
Even lasting as long as he has, and drawing number 3, he's made history.
Well, we're down to 10 seconds before we get another participant.
You know, it's not fair to Flair, and he's still in there.
Oh, please. A buzzer about to go off, there it goes. It's Sergeant Slaughter, former WWF champion.
310 pounds, and he is fresh. Hand-to-hand combat, this is his forte.
Well, when he hits the ring, there will be 2 former WWF champions inside. Only moments ago.
No, 3. Savage is still in there.
Macho Man's still in there. We had 4 in there only moments ago. And the Spinner, the Alligator Man, Skinner, has been eliminated. Well, there's one long
look
shot you won't have to worry about.
Look, you can tell how everybody fears Flair so much. As soon as they get in, they go right after him. That's the man you got to get out. You got to get Flair out.
Viper Hulk really going at it, showing you what it's all about. Every man for himself. Flair perched up there on the top turn.
Hit him.
Look at his chest, Monsoon. He's beat red.
Martel just about to be eliminated there by the Hulkster. And look at this. Flair is still attacking. Here comes another one. Oh, it's Sid Justice.
No.
Listen to this place go crazy.
I forgot about him.
Whoa. Justice fresh. That 330 pounds plus going to work. Picked up. IRS. Having a little trouble getting him over, though.
Where's Flair? Get that camera on Flair. Director, where is he? There he is.
Well, he got him over the top, but he didn't eliminate him, as IRS only went to the apron.
Keep a wide shot. Keep a wide shot. I got to see where Flair is at all times.
From the backside now. Hulkster being hooked by IRS, and Flair just unloading. Can you believe this? The guy's still punching.
What I tell you, Monsoon, man's a champion.
A lot of people say, you
know, he's proven that to me, Brain.
A lot of people can say and do things, but when he says it, he does it.
I always question the man's integrity. I never question his ability inside the ring.
He's never asked anybody to like him, but all you gotta do is respect him.
He has got to be physically exhausted. We've only got one entry left. No secret involved here. The guy who drew number 30 is going to be coming out in 5 seconds, and it'll be no surprise. It is the Warlock.
But you never know.
What
Tunney in the WWF will pull on you.
It can only be one guy.
I told you, the Warlord. I was right. I knew it, I was right. You may be looking at the new World Wrestling Federation champion.
Talk about the luck of the draw.
One of these men, Monsoon, is going to be champion.
Warlord doing, what's Flair doing outside the ring? How did he get there? Obviously, underneath that bottom rope, and now he's hooked. The Hulkster dragged him out there with her. Trying to suplex each other on the concrete. Oh, Hulk got him over.
Stay down, Rick.
That's proving yourself.
Stay down.
For Flair.
Stay down.
Look at this.
I can't sit anymore.
Oh, Slaughter's gone.
Slaughter's gone.
Justice just propelled him into that corner and up and out. Hulkster throwing Flair back in under that bottom rope.
Look at that. How can he keep going? Monsoon, how can he keep going?
Got me. I can't believe it. Hot Rod, Rowdy Roddy Piper.
How long's it been now?
It's been over an hour for Flair.
That's definitely not fair to Flair to be there that long. No human being should have to go through this. Shows you how bad he wants it. Shows you how bad he needs it.
Oh, look at this. IRS being hooked by the tie. Here, just teetering up there.
And Flair
went out.
Flair still taking it to Hogan.
Erwin R. Scheister eliminated at the hands of Rowdy Roddy Piper, the Intercontinental Champion. Oh, look at that. Hot Rod could hardly get to his feet.
Look at this, look at this. Look at the beef. You wonder where the beef is? There's the beef, pal.
There's the beef, he's right, and there goes the beef. What a surprise, Warlord out of there.
How long's Piper been in?
Hot Rod in excess of 35 minutes. What a tribute to him after winning the Intercontinental title earlier on from the Bounty. Oh, look at this. Oh, Justice just got rid of the both guys. Piper and Martel.
Who's left now?
It's Hulk.
One of those men in there are going to leave this ring World Wrestling Federation champion.
It's Justice and Savage. And look at Flair, I don't believe it. Randy
look at him.
Up there. Oh, Savage is gone.
Oh, my God.
And look at Flair.
Look at him. He keeps coming.
Still dishing out the punishment.
He's still coming at him.
I don't believe it. Upside down in the corner. Look at Justice just watching. Flair once again hooking that bottom rope. And looking from behind. Oh, Justice got rid of Hulk.
Uh-oh. I don't like the looks of things now. There are no friends. There are no friends. Only enemies.
Why is Hulk upset?
Quick,
he said. He said, you stole my belt.
Quick, quiet.
And look at this. Hulkster holding on, trying to pull him out. It's Flair from behind. Oh, yes.
Yes, 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 yes.
Flair did it.
Yes, 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 yes. He did it.
Just left the broadcast position to join the new World Wrestling Federation champion, Ric Flair. And two would-be champions left inside that ring. Oh, a lot of hatred shown here. the WWF officials to step between these two behemoths. Look at Justice, look at the Hulkster. He said, you robbed me of my title. These guys want out each other. Terry Garvin out there, Pat Patterson, Rene Goulet, Tony Garea. I don't know whether there's enough guys out there to keep these two apart. Was about to earlier on get rid of Ric Flair, and Justice was just standing by watching, and then from the back flipped out the Hulkster. There are no friends. But now there's enemies. That's pretty good. Who are odds on favorites. Of course, Ric Flair was a favorite as well, but drawing the number three, well, just about said goodbye to his chances, but he proved everybody wrong. Everybody in the world now knows what Ric Flair can do, what kind of man he is.
All right, by virtue of winning the Royal Rumble, we have a brand new World Wrestling Federation champion as the press watches on. At this time, to present the title belt to the new champion, our president, the distinguished Jack Tunney.
Congratulations, Ric Flair, on becoming the undisputed champion of the World Wrestling Federation.
Let me just say, after Vera distorting the belt, to proclaim me the real world champion, I'm going to tell you all, with a tear in my eye, this is the greatest moment in my life. When you walk around this world and you tell everybody you're number one, the only way you get to stay number one is to be number one. And this is the only title in the wrestling world that makes you number one. When you are the king of the WWF, you rule the world. Think about it like that, Mr. Perfect.
Guys, the brain.
Woo! Woo!
We did it. Woo!
Let's give a big one. Woo! Woo!
You did it.
I was never so impressed with anything I've ever seen in all my life. He went out there for over 60 minutes, never took a back step, took it to Hogan, took it to The Undertaker, took it to whoever got in that ring. That's why he is,
Bobby,
you can call now, the real world's heavyweight champion.
We're not the kind of guys to say, we told you so, but we told you so.
Okay, very good. Ric Flair, you have made world, put that cigarette out. You have made World Wrestling Federation history here tonight.
It's the greatest moment of my life. I want to jump. I want to party. But I got to tell you like this. For the Hulk Hogans and the Macho Mans and the Pipers and the Sids, now it's Ric Flair. And y'all pay homage to the man. Woo!